I'm going to save you a lot of time with the storyboard part of the design sprint process, which usually takes the entire day, but I'm going to show you how to do it in only a few hours. You're going to be learning all about the storyboard process in the design sprint, which usually people fear because it takes forever. But with what I'm going to tell you, you're going to save tons of time. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you can see many more tips on the design sprint, on innovation, on UX. Let's start. So I'm talking about the 4-day process instead of the 5-day process, but you can use this in the 5-day process as well. Usually people are really scared of the storyboarding process because there's so much misalignment, it's not very structured, and things can go wrong here. So I'm going to show you how to really save time and get alignment on this process. Just to remind everybody, this part happens after you've already chosen the winning concept, which looks like this. And now you have to plan what the user testing will be like. So usually you draw 8 rectangles on the board and you start from there. But I'm going to show you a little hack designed by AJ and Smart, which makes this process a lot quicker. It's called the user test flow. And in it, you get alignment on what the user testing is really going to be like. And after that, it's really going to help you create the storyboard. The first thing you're going to do is ask people to write 6 steps that the user is going to go through and make sure that each step is on a different post-it. So what's actually a step? Let me give you an example. User looks at their Instagram and clicks on a story. So for best practice, you should start with the first and last post-it first. So where the user starts and where you want the user to finish. Another thing to remember is to look at the can-wes. Because the point of the user testing is to get answers to those can-wes. So look at the can-wes, and when you create the user test flow, think which user test flow is best to answer those can-wes. The second thing you're going to want to do is ask each user to come up to the board and put up their 6 steps and read each one out loud without creating any discussions or anything, just to read each step out loud. The third step is to give everyone 1 red sticker and have them vote on a complete user flow. In the final step, the decider decides on a main user flow, and they can add 1 or 2 more post-its from the other suggestions. So finally, what you get is a 7 or 8 step process for the user flow. Again, remember that this user flow should be able to answer your can-wes. Now you're ready for storyboarding because you've already decided what the narrative will be like, and this will save you tons of time, actually hours. So the first thing you should do when you storyboard is take each post-it and put it on the top of each rectangle. Then you can go ahead and cut up parts of the solution and put them in the right frame. It doesn't even actually have to be parts of the winning solution. You can choose things that are relevant from other solutions just so that people can get an idea of what that screen will look like. Another thing you may want to consider is having different groups of people work on different frames so that you can save time. But if you chose the use part, it's best to start with the most complicated screen because that takes the longest to figure out. The best person to do this job is a UX or UI person, but if you don't have one, that's okay too. Try to be as exact as possible. These storyboards are going to be used the next day for the prototypers, and don't leave anything unanswered. Make sure that all the content is there, make sure that all the functionality is there, so you won't have any back and forth with the stakeholders the next day. These tips will definitely help you. It'll shorten the time that you storyboard, and it'll create much more alignment, and you'll have much better success at creating great prototypes. So if you guys have any questions or suggestions or anything to add, I'd love to hear them in the comments below. And if you like this video, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and you'll find a lot more videos that talk about design sprints, UX, UI, and most of all, innovation.